better than that. Now, it's my turn.
Rotten or pristine, each heart contains the secret of life. Drink at this river, try it all.
Oh, come on, you bastard! I won't bite!
Sir, please! You've lost too much blood. Calm yourself.
You think I didn't notice? Stop your staring and get me to an hospital, you arse!
Insulting a good Samaritan. Not exactly the way to get rescued.
All right, sorry. I am in pain here. My guts are spilling out onto the street and you're yabbering on.
Yes, that's a very nasty wound you've got there. Take my word, I am a doctor, Dr. Jonathan Reed.
Name's Clay Cox. I'd appreciate you helping me to a better place, Doc.
Follow me, Mr. Cox. Let me assist you to that better place.
Didn't have the guts to fart me. Fuck you. I'll kill you. I'll kill you.
To taste a life. To embrace its most intimate secrets. Such a burden. Such a divine sin.
I've little time to play hide-and-seek with new staff members, no matter how illustrious they may be.
I apologize, nurse. I needed some time to myself. This has been the longest and strangest night of my life.
You delivered poor Mr. Hampton from a terrible fate. The means to that end should be of little concern, Doctor.
Thank you, nurse. What can I do for you?
Dr. Swansea insisted we provide you a quiet office. You'll find it on the second floor with your name on the door.
Thank you. Nurse Crane, isn't it?
Yes, Dorothy Crane. Welcome to Pembroke Hospital, Dr. Reed. Your office has been prepared.
I would like to ask a few questions first. And Mr. Hampton, the patient we brought in. How does he fare?
I gave him a sedative to help him sleep. Poor thing was in quite a state of shock.
Thank you, Nurse Crane.
Dr. Swansea is right. This place seems perfect to conduct my research. This must be the place. It's definitely away from prying eyes. Relegated to the shadows. A kingdom of my own. At least I won't be sleeping in a coffin.
William Bishop's blood is much more unstable than human blood and shows extensive mutation. But this is not what happened to me. I must keep on searching. The sun is about to rise. I can feel it. I'll continue tomorrow night. I have so much time now. If I'm to stay here until my research is complete, I'd better learn to hide my true nature from the mortals. But what about my thirst for blood?
Hurry now, it's freezing here.
Yes, Nurse Crane? How can I help you?
I'm so sorry. I know Dr. Swansea wanted you to rest, but we have somewhat of a crisis.
A crisis, you say?
Our supply of antiseptics is nearly depleted. I was hoping there was another box up here, but...
What type of hospital are you running? No antiseptics?
You have been away too long, Doctor. With the war, and now this epidemic, supplies have been running scarce for months now.
I may have a solution. In France, during the war, drugs shortage was a daily problem, and we had to use our wits to overcome the shortages.
However do you mean?
If combined correctly, certain household chemical products can be used in a pinch instead. Now, where's the hospital storeroom?
The storeroom? Fat chance. This is the Pembroke, and space is luxury we don't have. Everything used to be stored in the old morgue.
Perhaps I should look there first. Where is this morgue?
It's the large building behind the hospital. You'll need to go in the back door because it's been sealed off for sanitary reasons. Take this key. It opens a small back entrance at the end of a narrow street.
The abandoned morgue behind the hospital. A small door at the end of a narrow street. On my way, then. Thank you, nurse.
Strain. This sickness moves faster than influenza. This key will surely grant me access to the basement. It's locked. Balls of Mars, fortifiers. As popular as they are, ineffective. But they do contain iron tartrate, and that might prove itself useful. Mr. Connor's injuries don't match. the report. I'd better look into this. It's locked. I'm not sure I can defeat them without becoming stronger. To drink blood is so tempting.
always knew the words to calm the children, Helen. As for me, I'm a London idiot.
Finally, you've returned, Doctor. Did you find anything of value?
Yes, nurse.
You've worked your first miracle, Doctor. Now, this patient here needs immediate treatment.
Duty calls? When the storm has passed, I'll show you how to mix the remedy yourself with the same basic ingredients.
Many thanks, Doctor. When you've finished, you ought to report to Dr. Swansea in his office. He's been looking for you. Seemed pressing.
As for me, I'm a blundering idiot.